Hello fellow crafters, today I'm back with another xTool tutorial, but this time I'm using a top-of-the-line laser cutting machine to show you how to cut acrylic at home. I'll be using the brand new pearl white model of the P2 that just launched this week. The P2 is a 55-watt CO2 laser, which has the ability to cut materials up to 20 millimeters thick in a single pass. Big thanks to xTool for sponsoring this video, and be sure to check out the promo code down in the description box for a special discount that's a limited time offer. There are lots of different types of acrylic sheets you can cut with a laser, from opaque acrylic like this one to mirror acrylic, which has a very high shine or glossy finish. You'll notice that these acrylic sheets have either a plastic masking or a paper masking. You always want to remove the plastic masking from both sides before laser cutting. So let's get started by making some swizzle sticks. For this first project, I'm going to get started in xTool Creative Space. This is the software that comes with all xTool machines. And I'm going to just add a square or rectangle shape to my canvas here. By unlocking the size, I can drag and resize this rectangle to any dimension I like. And then I'm going to go ahead and add a little circle to the end here to make our swizzle stick look nice and professional. And once I have those aligned, I'm going to unite them under the combine menu and then just make a few copies, because we're gonna create a few little Valentine's themed swizzle sticks here. So I'm gonna start by adding a heart or different heart designs to different swizzle sticks here. And then in a moment, we'll add a few words like love and XO. You can change the font to any font you like and resize it however you need to. I'm going to choose a font called Lobster that has a little bit of a script, but not too much. And you'll notice that the letters overlap a little bit. So we're gonna go ahead and take care of that by adjusting the spacing and then clicking weld to make sure that they all cut as one word. Once you have everything aligned, you'll want to click and drag to select the entire object and click Unite for each of the swizzle sticks. For the double heart pattern, you will have to click Subtract at Overlap to remove that inner heart from the outer one before you click Unite. Now we're going to select Cut as the processing type. Then we'll choose Slats Flat as our format here. And for the material type, I'm choosing a 3 millimeter transparent acrylic because I'm using this iridescent acrylic sheet. When you hit refresh in the XCS software, you'll see a live preview of your project. I love this feature. The P2 has dual 16 megapixel cameras that allow you to view your project in real time. So then you can format it however you like. I'm going to flip some of these swizzle sticks upside down so that I can squeeze more in together and save some acrylic. But I love that you can use this camera feature to do all of this little fine tuning. Once we're satisfied with everything, we just need to enter power, speed, and passes. I'm using 60 for the power and 8 for speed with one pass. I'm just gonna select all of this, check my settings one last time before I hit process to send this to the machine. I'm gonna hit start in the software, but before we cut, let's talk a little bit about safety.
You'll definitely wanna take some safety precautions when using a CO2 laser like the P2. One of the things you want is a way to extinguish a fire just in case a fire were to break out in your machine. Now, the best tool that I would recommend for this is the fire safety kit that xTool sells. Right now you can get it for free when you purchase a P2, but you should definitely look into that if it doesn't come included. The other thing you'll want to think about is proper ventilation. So you definitely want to vent to the outside. And what I like to personally use that comes recommended also is a respirator like this one. It's not that expensive and it just prevents you from inhaling some of those fumes because they can be quite strong, even though they're not lethal. You just want to take precautions, especially if you're sensitive to strong odors. The final thing you want to consider is having a smoke purifier. This is sold separately, but it just helps with ventilation as well. It helps to purify some of the air that's coming out of your P2. It's sold separately, so you can get something like that. Some users also like the option to have an inline fan. xTool has one that just came out recently. I haven't tried it myself, but it's another option to help get those fumes out of your machine and make sure that they don't linger in your workspace.
Once you have all of your safety precautions in place, it's time to start cutting. This is the actual speed of the P2 as it's cutting this acrylic sheet. You can see it's very fast. This whole operation only took about 4.5 minutes. I'm amazed at how fast that was. Let's take a look at how these turned out.
I think these stir sticks are just so cute. I love that they have different colors and the light. It's very iridescent. This is gonna be great for Valentine's Day. I do love that the P2 can cut this transparent acrylic. Whether you're into the Stanley Tumbler craze or not, the fact is they are super popular right now. And one of the items that is very hot on Etsy is the personalized nameplate. I'm going to show you how to do that out of acrylic, and you can use these for gifts for yourself and family, or you can start to sell them online through an Etsy or Shopify store.
I purchased an SVG file on Etsy for the main nameplate, and now I'm just inputting my settings to cut at a power of 60 and a speed of 8. For the material type, I'm gonna go ahead and look at the different options here. I'm using an opaque acrylic, so I think a white acrylic is gonna be fine. This is just really to get the thickness. So you'll see when I click this, it comes out to 3 millimeter thickness. I'm gonna personalize this with my name, and I'm choosing a really cute script font that has a little heart over the eye. I will link to this font down below if you're interested, but I think it's perfect for Valentine's Day or anything with a heart theme. Now, again, anytime we use a script font, we need to weld the letters so that the laser will not cut the letters separately. And then I'll just resize it to fit the nameplate, since I know my nameplate is the right dimension for a Stanley. I'm gonna go ahead and select the whole nameplate and then choose subtract at overlap just to make sure that those are joined together. And then you can always move different elements to different layers by color. This is sometimes handy if you wanna process things by different layers. The other thing you can do is select to ignore a certain shape. I'm gonna do that here because I'm cutting these out of two different colors of acrylic, so I don't want it to cut both out of the same sheet. I'm using the same settings of power of 60 and a speed of 8 with one pass for both pieces of acrylic. I went ahead and used the material clamps to keep the acrylic sheet in place. I do think it's helpful so that none of the pieces shift around on you while you're laser cutting. Once we have everything set, we can click refresh in the software and we will see our acrylic sheet pop up. Then I can move things around and make sure it's cutting exactly where I want it to. You can see it's going to ignore the blue acrylic piece and it's going to output my name. So now that I'm ready, I just hit start and then send this to the machine. I'm gonna do the same thing for my teal acrylic base plate, and altogether these two cuts took less than 3 minutes. This is such a fun color for a Stanley Tumbler nameplate, and I think the name turned out really cute as well. To attach the two pieces of acrylic, you can either use a double-sided 3M tape before you laser cut, or you can use an acrylic adhesive. For this last project, we'll make a cake topper, and I'm gonna do a Valentine's Day themed cake topper that says Be Mine. So I'm gonna start with my text, and then I will change it to the same font that I used for the Stanley Tumbler name. Again, because I have overlapping letters, I wanna weld the letters together for both words. Then I'm going to select the words together, just click and drag, and choose Unite so that this cuts as one image together in the machine. Now we're gonna create an outline for our cake topper. So I'm gonna create an offset,
And this offset is going to be made of clear acrylic, whereas the Be Mine words I'm going to do in gold mirror acrylic. Now I'm going to add some rectangles, just like we did in our first project. These are going to become the stakes so I can actually put this sign in my cake. I'm going to go ahead and move the text out of the way so that I can finish making this background layer. One trick when you're trying to center things is to select both of these rectangles and group them together. Then you can select the topper piece and choose horizontal align center. That'll center everything up before we unite these pieces together. But first I want to add a few little triangles on bottom so that they look more like a steak and will go into the cake really nice and smoothly. Now it's simply a matter of uniting all of these pieces. Once it's united, you should not see any overlapping lines. I'm going to enter the same cut settings as before, changing the power and the speed, and then we will load these acrylic sheets into the P2 and get started laser cutting. With this gold mirror acrylic, I have removed the plastic backing from the shiny side, and I'm actually placing it face down in the P2. Once we refresh the image in the software, you'll see that acrylic sheet in there. And now since we've placed it face down, I'm going to take my Be Mine text here and I'm just going to reflect it horizontally up here in the menu. This is going to make sure that it cuts with the right direction when we flip it over on the shiny side. So this took only a couple of minutes to get these words cut out. And you do want to, again, never leave your machine unattended and monitor the process during laser cutting. Since the clear acrylic had a paper masking, I just went ahead and left it on to show you what that looks like. You can do that for paper, just not for plastic. I'm moving my design over and now I'm going to output the clear backing design. So I'll switch that over in the vector settings here. Then I will enter my power and speed settings and begin cutting. After about 2 minutes, this piece was done as well, so then it was just a matter of assembling my cake topper. Once I removed the paper masking, I just glued these pieces together using some 3M double-sided tape, and I'll link to some options down below for acrylic glue. I think these projects turned out great, but if you're just getting started with laser cutting, I'm gonna put a link here to my M1 review, which is a great beginner laser cutting machine. I'll see you next time.